And the investigation at the Prince Street garage had a major impact, as you heard, on nearby residents and businesses, including those trying to get in and out of the city. News 8's Meredith Jorgensen continues our live team coverage with that part of the story. Meredith?
Hi, Susan. What a difference a little time makes. It was a ghost town here just a short while ago, but it's starting to pick up here in downtown. Now, this is the downtown, so you can imagine how many businesses and residents were affected by this incident. City officials went door to door around 3 a.m. this morning, evacuating people. And thanks to Franklin and Marshall College's emergency plan, those evacuees had a place to go. Called on early in the morning, F&M facility managers opened up the college's sports complex and set up for an influx of people. About 30 people showed up to wait out this bomb threat. Some walked from the Prince Street area to the college. Others, who were able to get to their cars, drove, and police even transported a few evacuees to that sports complex. F&M was able to provide tea and coffee and some pastries for the people gathered there. And the men and women who had to be evacuated say at least they're thankful they had a place to go.
I was really surprised because I had just went to bed about 1 a.m. Get woke up about 2 hours later.
Even though it caused a lot of maybe personal chaos, it was for the safety of the public. And since it was the safety of the public that was at hand, I don't feel too bad about it.
Now, some of the people gathered there say there might be concerns that the city overreacted by evacuating all of these people, but the men and women that we spoke to say it's better safe than sorry. We did ask the police point blank, is everyone in the downtown area safe? And they said yes. Susan, that's the latest here. Back to you.
All right. Very good, Meredith.